Iris Commander offers us tools that will allow us to quickly and easily make a selection of entities in a drawing. As you already know, if we click on the drawing area and move the pointer to the left, we get a capture selection window, which color is green. All those entities that are included or touching its border will be selected when a second click is made. On the other hand, if we click and move the mouse to the right, we make a window selection, which color is blue. This option is only capable of selecting those entities that are entirely inside area, excluding the entities that are crossed and not fully inside. Additionally, we found now in Iris Commander a new lasso selection method. For that, you have to hold down the left mouse button and keep dragging your mouse to draw an irregular shape. Just like with the window selection method, you may do this from right to left or left to right. Again, doing a lasso selection to the left will show a green color, and this will capture the entities that are only crossing the border as well as those inside. Then we may, for example, delete the selected entities. Likewise, if we leave the pointer pressed and move it to the right, we would also be using lasso, but we see a blue color. Only the entities entirely inside the blue selection area will be kept. Note that the system variable pick auto has to be at 5 for the selection named lasso to work. It should not be forgotten that from options, all of the program parameters can be controlled. To do this, from user preferences in the drafting options section, we select entity selection to finally find selection settings, where you can see the option that allows you to activate lasso. If we disable it, then even if we hold down the pointer, lasso will not work. In turn, if we enter the system variable pick auto, we can verify that it has another value, in this case, 1. And as we said before, it has to be at 5. We can activate it directly, writing the value, or from options, as we saw before. With all these selection options, we could combine them and make a selection of the window type, a selection of the crossing type, or of the lasso type. Either way. As of course, an individual selection. Multiple selection methods that do not end here, because from the properties palette, we have more options using the selection filters. In any case, by doing a quick review of these icons, we can say that it's used to select elements with some of the options that we saw earlier. After pressing enter after selecting, all the categories of the selected entities appear in the drop-down of the properties palette. The first of the icons can deactivate the selection. Look at the following icon. It has two positions. When displayed with a single arrow, it means that with each new selection, it deselects the previous one. Look, we make a selection, and then we're going to select a new group. The first elements are automatically deselected. Instead, when the icon shows several arrows, we can select more entities that will accumulate to the previous selections. By pressing Escape, we can cancel all the selections. Likewise, if we make a selection of elements in general. Note that in the Properties palette, it says All because there is more than one category selected, in addition to indicating the number of selected entities. When deploying it, we can choose, for example, the blocks. Thus, the properties palette will show us the properties of these particular objects. If we change to line, the type of property shown will also change. Now pay attention to this other icon. This is the smart select, where we will be able to search for elements in the entire drawing or in a specific group with this icon. Note that we can combine here different conditions. First, let's determine the type of entities. In this case, we want to select only blocks. Now we define some properties. In this case, it says that the color of the lines are equal to the layer color, that is, bilayer. We could search for blocks with attributes and specify a specific attribute. For example, find all the blocks from the same manufacturer. Or perhaps a product code to identify the furniture. In this example, we're going to tell it to be equal to this code. We could also tell it to be instead different from that particular code, in order to exclude one in particular. With all these options, we will be able to do an intelligent search for objects in the whole drawing or in a part of the drawing. We leave it as it was at the beginning and click OK. This will select the 25 blocks that appear in this part of the drawing. We go back to the smart selection. We choose the blocks again, and more will appear because now we define to search in all the drawing. To learn more about the selection methods in Ares Commander, be sure to visit the extensive help that the program offers.